Hey guys, Martin speaking. Another video in the Dark Eldar Tactics. This time is on Venoms. This isn't a complete model. Bits missing out of its early stages, but we all know what the model looks like. It's a cool looking model. Again, as I said with the Reavers, this isn't about the model though, it's about what it does in the game. So, I take three of these in my 1500 point list. Two with Cabalite Warriors inside, and one with an Archon, and three Incubi inside. I don't bother with the Raiders. They're a couple of points more, and they just don't do as much. Fine, they can transport as twice as many people as this, but I'd sooner have two of these. I arm them with, again, it's not on this model. They all come with a splinter cannon anyway, and you can upgrade to have a second splinter cannon, which I do. Which means we'll forget about the guys inside. This thing on its own can put out 12. 24-inch shots. That's ridiculous. Absolutely fantastic amount of shots. 12 shots. Even if you've had to jink, you're still going to roll a couple of sixes out of 12 shots. You would want to believe. Law of averages said really you should be rolling two. Might have got the math wrong there. I don't know, guys. I magnetized my same as with the jet bikes. But yeah, they're just putting out 4-up poison shots, so Wraith Knights don't like these. Put 12 shots into a Wraith Knight, he's needing those 3-up saves. You could take a Wraith Knight out with one, definitely with two of these. Let's say I run three with the jet bikes. The guys inside, let's say we're going with the Cabalite Warriors, they've got 5 shots with their splinter rifles. Important thing to remember, I think I did touch on it in the overview video of my army. If this jinks, the guys inside don't get penalised for it. They still shoot at normal ballistic skill. But what you've got to ask yourself, guys, on there's only 2 hull points, and they're only armour 10 all round, so they're fragile, and we know we're going to lose them. You can take your jink save, which is a 4+, or you get a 5+ invulnerable save anyway. It just might be worth not jinking, so that if you survive, you get the full shots off. It's only one number better. I don't know. I tend to just weigh it up as to how many shots are going to be coming into me before I decide whether to jink or use the invul. But they're a fantastic little bit of kit. Very, very manoeuvrable. And the great 5 guys inside, get them whizzed across the table, take some shots. Next turn, maybe just move them to 6 inches. Because they're open tops, you can disembark 6 and then still charge 12. So actually, you're getting a 24-inch movement for the guys inside, or a 24-inch charge, if you like, for the guys inside, if you roll really, really, really well. But they're just a fantastic little unit. Whatever you put inside them, you run racks in them with a liquefier gun. I got an Archon. He's got a blast pistol, and then the Incubi, no weapons, but it's fine. This thing zips across, shoots its guns, and then they disembark as and when they need to, and they jump back in. And with everything being scoring now as well, fast little units like this are fantastic. If you've still got them at turn 4 or 5, then they're great for just running across. Forget about them shooting, but use the turbo boost on them, or flat out, whatever you want to call it. Which is another 18 inches, and just drop onto an objective. They're not objective secured, so if there's troops of the enemy there, then tough, you're not getting them. But just drop onto an objective and you're just getting the point. They're so quick, and that's the whole thing with Dark Eldar. You can run a very, very quick army with this and the jet bikes. That's exactly what I do. So yeah, much quicker than the Reaver video, because they're not more limited, but they're shorter in what they do. So hope you've enjoyed the video, guys. As always, if you like it, press the like button. If I've got anything wrong, leave me a comment, and then let me know what you think. Cheers, guys. See you soon.